Number one, obedience makes serving God easier. That's wrong. People tend to think that if you are obeying the Lord, your service will be easy or easier. That is not true. Obedience does not make service easier.
That's right. That's right.
Another misconception is God calls us to serve because our faith is strong.
Yes.
See how that man served God? His faith is stronger than anyone else's.
Yeah.
That is wrong. No, grace is God's ability. Faith is man's responsibility.
Yeah.
When grace and faith are wed, then the result is glorious. But it takes God reaching down in grace and the preacher reaching up in faith in order for things to happen. Another misconception is that God's will is sabotaged by the devil. No, that's wrong. No, when God's will is sabotaged, it is not the devil, it is our flesh.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
It is our doubt. It is our not obeying God that gets us in trouble. Satan has no authority in the church, nor does he have authority against the church. Jesus himself said, upon this rock, I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. The Bible even tells us that if we draw near to God, he will draw near to us. Now the first draw near has to do with our approach. If we approach God, then God will draw near, but we can't say that God will approach us because he's already everywhere.
Yes, sir.
But when the Bible said God will draw near to us, it means that God will be in our face. We cannot escape him. And then when the Bible said, greater is he who is in you than he that is in the world, meaning the devil cannot stop the church. But the church can stop the church. The church can rebel against the will of God. The church can vote to sin against the vision of God. You see, in church, the vision and the visionary are one. We don't call a new pastor and say to the new pastor, this is our vision. We don't have a vision. The visionary brings the vision. So when the new pastor comes, they bring the vision for the future.
Yes.
You said, but we already had a vision. No, that vision belonged to the pastor you used to have.
Yeah.
But the new pastor brings the new vision. And whenever you have a vision, it has to be driven by the will of the people to support the visionary.
Yeah.
That's why we pray for our pastors, that they don't fall in battle. Because if we lose our pastor, what will our young people do? What will our ministers do? We will have to scramble and scrape and start all over again. And it may take years before the next man with the next vision can get leadership in perspective. And so we have to understand, when it comes to serving God, God uses ordinary people, not fantastic people, not faith-strong people, ordinary people. He can take one person that's yielded to his will and turn the world upside down. And we have to learn to obey God even when we don't understand it. Because obedience is our duty. Obedience is our debt. Obedience should be our delight. Obedience should be our decision to follow God.
Amen.
And in the Bible, when you study pastoring, the only example we really have is Moses.
That's right.
Now you look at Paul, but Paul with them for 2 to 3 years and moved on. He would write them letters back to correct anything he'd heard in the rumor mill. But in the Bible, the only one to sit with people year after year, after year, after decade after decade, is Moses. The relationship between Moses and God, Moses and the people, is central to leadership. And you notice, if you study Moses for these few minutes, there's a lot of contradictions in his call. Contradiction one is the call itself. Would you say the call? Would you say the call? Would you say the call? You see, it's even interesting that God, when he wants somebody, would call Moses. Because nothing was right about Moses. You remember Moses, right? God called Moses, who was a fugitive, justice. Moses was a murderer. Moses was a loser. Yes, he was born in tough times. And yes, by God's will, he grew up in Pharaoh's palace. Under the guardianship of Pharaoh's daughter. But he lost all of that. He was in line to be the next leader in Egypt. But he lost all of that. He was a prince in Egypt that committed murder at 40 years old. Could Moses pastor you? A man that was a murderer? Oh, I know we like to talk about every preacher's resume, but what about his rap sheet? Because the truth is, everybody in this room has both a resume and a rap sheet. can't even talk to me. A bush.